Today on For Yarn's Sake, we're going to learn how to make this very cute and very functional water bottle holder. So grab your supplies and let's get started. For this, we're going to need, once again, our worsted weight yarn. And today I'm going to be using a 5mm crochet hook. For the first row, we're going to actually be crocheting in the round today. So for the first round, we'll just make our magic ring with 6 single crochets right inside. 1 and oops. Then we go with 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Go ahead and pull that tight, and then we'll go on to round number 2, which we're going to increase the 6 up to 12. So we're going to put 1 single crochet in each stitch around. So let's find our first stitch, counting backwards, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And just insert your hook right there into the very first stitch. And we're going to put 2 single crochets in each stitch around. And I always like to make sure I'm crocheting over my yarn tail over the first couple of stitches, so we can get it nice and secure over there. So why don't you go ahead and do that, and we'll meet you back here when that's all done. Okay, for our third yarn, for our third round, we're going to take our yarn tail that we use as our stitch marker, put it in place right there, and we're going to increase from 12 to 18 by putting 1 single crochet in the first stitch, two single crochets in the next stitch, and just following that along all the way around till we get to the stitch marker. So that's 1 single crochet and then an increase of 2. So go ahead and do that all the way around, and we'll see you back here when we reach the stitch marker. All right, here we are back at our stitch marker for round number 4. Round number 4, we're going to increase again by placing a single crochet in the first stitch, a single crochet in the second stitch, and then in the third stitch we will increase just like so. And you just want to follow that again all the way around to the stitch marker. So that's a single crochet right there in the first stitch, a single crochet in the second stitch, and then the third stitch we're going to increase by putting 2 single crochets right in there. And once again, we'll meet you right back here at the stitch marker, and we'll continue on. All right, now we're all done with round number 4. On to round number 5, and we're going to put a single crochet in the next 3 stitches, and just by going 1, and a single crochet in the second, and a single crochet in the third, and then the fourth, you guessed it, we will put in our increase by putting 2 single crochets right there in that stitch. So go ahead and get that all the way around. Well, that's 1 single crochet in the second, 1 single crochet in the third, and then in the fourth, we put our double crochet, or our single crochet increase by 2 single crochets right in the same stitch, and we'll meet you right back here at the stitch marker. All right, now this is going to be, we're going to be on round 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 we've completed, and this will be round 6. Round 6 will be our final increase round. So in this one, we're going to be putting a single crochet into the next 4 stitches, and then an increase in the 5th. So we're just going to do 1 single crochet in the 1st, 2nd, 3rd, and then 4th, and then an increase in the 5th, just like that. And just keep following that all the way around. And when we get back, we're going to be start growing this up, and it's going to start looking like a water bottle holder. Okay, now we have our 6 rows done, rounds done rather. I'm going to go ahead and pull out my yarn tail for now. I'm going to pull out my hook, and I'm going to take my water bottle that I like to use. This is a Smart Water, not a sponsor. And we're going to just measure it against our bottom. If you haven't guessed, this will be our bottom of our water bottle holder. And we're just going to place it here just to make sure it matches like we want. And it looks like it's just about perfect, because I like my bottles to fit in there nice and snug. If you have a bottle that's going to be a little bit larger than this, it's a pretty standard size. It's about as big as a 20-ounce bottle and whatnot. But if you have a bigger one, go ahead and keep increasing around in the same interval by 6 stitches each time. But when you get done with that, we're going to go ahead and move on to our next round, where we're going to start growing this up. So now in order to do that, we're going to take and do one round of just one single crochet all the way around, but we're going to put the single crochets in the back loops only. Now if we go ahead and take a look at the stitches here, and let's see if I can get a nice zoom on this. Okay, you can see that there's a front loop and a back loop on here. And we're going to put it in this back loop over here. Okay, and I'll show you just how that's going to look. So we'll just take our single crochet, take our hook into the very first stitch, and we're just going to, instead of going through both like that, which we don't want to do, we want to just go through the very back loop, and that's gonna look like that. So just go ahead and insert your hook into the back loop. So you're skipping both loops and just going into the one in the back, and go ahead and do that all the way around until we once again reach our stitch marker. And what that's going to do, let me put a couple in here, and then you'll be able to see exactly what that's going to do. You can see already there's a little ridge here. That little ridge there, that's the loop that we didn't put our hook through. And what it's going to allow this to do is bend up. So the sides will go up, and this will be a distinct bottom. So go ahead and do that all the way around, and we'll meet back up here and start working on our lovely pattern. All right, now we're all the way back around, and you can probably already tell how this is starting to move up as a side, and the bottom is getting a little more distinct. So let's go ahead and get started with our pattern. We're gonna move our yarn tail up to mark our stitch, and this is the next round is gonna be our lovely little pattern, and let's take a look at the finished one here. And you can see it's got a little cross pattern here. And that's what we're gonna do. We're gonna take double crochets. And if anyone is confused about a double crochet, go ahead and pause the video. Go on over to our double crochet video and refresh yourself and come on back. And then what we're gonna do is we're gonna put a double crochet. We're not gonna do it in the first stitch. We're gonna skip over into the second stitch from the stitch marker and put a double crochet in there. Okay, and that's all there is. And then now we're going to go back to the first one and go ahead and put a double crochet right in there. And there we have our little cross. Nothing could be easier than that. So on the next one, we'll go ahead and skip one, put our double crochet in the second. All right, and then go ahead, go back one and put a double crochet back in that first stitch. And we're going to do that just all the way around. One more time, there's one, skip one, go into the second, put in your double crochet, and then go ahead and go back one and put a double crochet right in there, and just go ahead and do that all the way around, and we'll meet you back here at the stitch marker. All right, we're all the way back around, and it's already looking so good. So the next part of our repeating pattern here, we're gonna go ahead and move our stitch marker up, and then for the next four rounds, all we're gonna do is put one single crochet in each round, or in each stitch rather. So you just find your first stitch and go ahead and put a single crochet in it. And there should be 36 stitches around. So if you wanna go ahead and count as you go around, and when you reach your stitch marker, you should be at a stitch count of 36. And if you are, you know that you are right where you should be for your stitch count. This is assuming, of course, you didn't make yours any larger or smaller. But if you're following the pattern just as it is, there should be 36 stitches all the way around. So go ahead and do one single crochet in each stitch all the way around for the next four rows. And we'll see you back here when that's all done. Okay, so now we've made it all the way back around. And I actually went ahead and went all the way up with mine. And so we can show you how it looks here. We're going to go ahead and just repeat that pattern three more times. So we're going to have four sets. We have one, two, three, and four sets. We'll have one set of the cross double crochets, and then one set of the four single crochets around. You're gonna do that three more times, all the way up. If you want your water bottle holder to be a little bit taller, go ahead and add a couple more sets. If you want it to be a little shorter, go ahead and leave off one. It's a very versatile pattern, very easy to fit your needs and what you need. So go ahead and do all that, and when you get to the length that you want, meet us back here, and we'll go ahead and put a handle on this guy. Okay, and we're back. So the handle that I found that works just the best for this water bottle holder, this nice simple water bottle holder, is we're going to go ahead and you be working with two strands of yarn together. Now I've chosen this nice green color here to kind of complement my gold color, to make it give it a little bit of color to the project. If you want to use both the same color, go ahead. Just go ahead and work with the same strand of yarn on both sides. And we're going to go ahead and do everything we would normally do. We're just doing it with two strands of yarn this time. We're going to still use our 5mm hook. And this is going to give it a little bit more toughness for the handle. It won't be so springy. So we're going to go ahead and start out with making a slip knot. And I'm going to attach it right here, just right here to the project before we start working. We're going to go ahead and find the stitch we tied off on. I find that's the best place to start out again, but you can start anywhere on the project you want. And I'm just going to go ahead and start out by putting the slip knot right in there, right like so. And now our handle is attached to our project. And now what we're going to do is we're going to chain 150 chains. So you just keep going 150 chains. We go 1, 2. Oh, see there, it's pretty easy if you're not paying attention or if you're filming a YouTube video to not catch both the strands of yarn there when you're doing your chaining. So you just go ahead, you have to make sure you're looping both chains around the hook and pulling both chains through the loop. So go ahead and do that 150 times, and when we meet back here, we'll get this handle finished off. Okay, here we are back, and we have our 150 chains. So now what we're going to do from here is go ahead and actually add one more. Just get your chain so it's all not twisted. And go ahead and add one more chain. And we're going to go ahead and crochet all the way back down this chain. We're going to skip the first chain. And then in the second chain for the hook, I'm just going to go ahead and put a half double crochet. And go ahead and go to the next one and just put a half double crochet, and we're going to do that all the way back down the chain until we reach the bottom. And when we get back, we should be all have that all done, and we'll be almost done with our water bottle project here. Right, so we made it all the way back down, putting a half double crochet in our in each stitch of our strap here, and we're going to just take this. And now we're going to attach it to our project here. So the way I'm going to do that is I'm just going to go and take and go into this very first stitch right next to where we attached it. And we're going to put a slip stitch right in there. And then in the next stitch, we're going to put in another slip stitch. Just right with both yarns like we've been doing, like we did all the way down. And that's that. And now we're going to take, and I'm going to chain one and turn the work. And then we're going to go all the way back down our strap here. And we're just going to put, just find the next stitch on the strap. And we're just going to put a slip stitch into each stitch all the way down until we reach the other side. And then we're going to attach the other side to our project, and we will be just about done with our water bottle holder. All right, now we made it all the way back down with our slip stitches, and our strap is now complete. The only thing left to do is now to attach the strap to the other side. So we're going to go ahead and fold this in half. Make sure each half here looks just about even here on either side. And then we're going to find the middle point here, and go ahead and attach it to the other side of the water bottle holder. But the first thing you should always do is make sure your strap is not tangled or twisted in any way. So just pull it tight, make sure it's not tangled or twisted, and then go ahead and find your first stitch that you're going to attach this to. Make sure it's on just on the opposite side over there, and go ahead and attach it with a slip stitch. Just like so, and now we're all attached, and we're going to, once again, making sure this doesn't get twisted at all, we're going to put a slip stitch straight through the project here, and then catch the next stitch, go through both, just like so. And we're going to do that one more time. Go ahead and catch the end of the strap, and then go ahead and go through the next stitch, and then pull through both, and just make a slip stitch. And tying it on is just that simple, like that. And now you have a strap right there on the other side. So go ahead, and we're going to just finish off by tying off our yarn. Grab your scissors, leave yourself a decent sized tail so you can hide them in your project. Go ahead and cut it off. I don't want to make my knot here. Just like so. And we are all finished. This is one of the simplest bottle holders you're going to make. You're going to use it all the time, and it's just going to look great. So go ahead and hide your yarn tails. I'm going to hide mine. And join us back here next time on For Yarn's Sake, where we're going to make some more incredible gifts. Thank you all for joining us today. Check out one of our other videos here. Go ahead and click on the little circle button to subscribe to the channel. And as always, leave a comment down below with all your current projects. We always love to see what's going on. And we'll see you back here again next time.